Good morning, this is Matthew from NWS Norman with an update on this weekend's weather. The main weather story this weekend is freezing rain and some sleet across parts of northern and western Oklahoma. We will also continue to see moderate to heavy rains in the southeast leading to potential flooding. Here's the temperature map from the MesoNet as of 9:30 this morning. Now for the latest temperatures, you can always check their website at mesonet.org. As you can see, the freezing line has already made it a good ways into Oklahoma, extending from Hollis to Reno to Newkirk. Behind this lane, freezing rain and sleet has already begun early this morning. Freezing temperatures may advance a little bit more this afternoon to Oklahoma City, but not much farther than that, though it's the uncertainty in how this line continues to set up and how far it progresses that presents the greatest challenge to this forecast. Here are the precipitation types we're expecting through this afternoon. Again, sleet and freezing rain to the northwest, while rain continues to the southeast. As the freezing line slowly advances this evening, so will the freezing rain, with minor impacts to Oklahoma City, Lawton, and Stillwater. And finally, by early tomorrow morning, the freezing line will have reached its southeast extent before beginning its slow retreat tomorrow afternoon. There is some uncertainty in how far southeast the freezing line will make it, so be sure to check back for the latest information. Overall, most places behind the freezing line can expect to see a tenth to a quarter inch of ice accumulation. Some areas in western Oklahoma may see up to half an inch of ice accumulation. Impacts may include some power outages as well as slick roads, making travel hazardous. Be careful if you're traveling. Areas around Stillwater to Oklahoma City shouldn't see much more than a light glazing with minor impacts, but again, there is some uncertainty in where the freezing line stops, so there's a potential that those tenth to a quarter inch amounts may show up further east. As new data comes in, we'll be looking at those questions later today, so be sure to check back with us. The second threat we have to look at is the heavy rain in the southeast. As you can see, we have amounts up to 6 to 8 inches. That includes, you know, what we got yesterday through Sunday morning, possible in the southeast. With this rainfall continuing through Sunday morning, there's the possibility of flooding and river flooding. Also be careful if you're on the road, as heavy rainfall could lead to reduced visibility. Finally, here's a look at our current watches and warnings and advisories. There's a lot on this map, but the most notable is the ice storm warning in the northwest and the flash flood watch in the southeast. And here's a list of phone numbers that can provide you with road information for Oklahoma and Texas and surrounding states. Go ahead and pause if you need to write a few of these down. And with that, thanks for watching. Hope you had a happy Thanksgiving, and remember to stay safe out there.